Hi everybody, very excited to be with you today and thanks you for spending some time with me to talk about TEE, Trusted Execution Environment, and also potential collaboration between Global Platform, my organization, and RISC-V. So let me introduce, I'm Gilles Bernabeu. I'm the technical director of Global Platform. Global Platform, it's a unique platform and technical community that regroup multiple actors from various verticals that are working together to reduce the time to market for digital services. And this is very important to have both device manufacturer, chip manufacturer, service provider, and of course all the actors that are developing the technology to really work together. And we have been quite successful in the last 20 years of evolution of the organization. Global Platform is a member-driven organization, so I'm not the one to develop the technology, but you see here many actors that are participating to this platform, and the technology is a result of their effort. So when we talk about deployment of secure technology, this requires for us three main activities. Of course, we need first to protect the assets. This is very important. We know that protecting is one, but we need to be sure that the protection is answering to a specific request of the market. So this is why the certification is very, very important. And also, in today's connected world, connectivity provide an enormous capability to update the objects, the devices. So we need to have a secure management of the devices. In order to protect digital services, very briefly, we have two types of technology within Global Platform. A technology that is really how to get access to service provider and application to trust sources within the device. So this is the device trust architecture. I will not talk about that today. I will more focus on the secure component. Today we have two technologies, the secure element technology and the trusted execution environment. And where we are currently adding a view which is more about MCU, secure MCU that are critical for the IoT world. Global Platform has been very successful. You see here some figures about deployment. Secure Element Technology was a primary technology, so we are now at 42 billions since we are tracking the figures. It's always difficult to, but we are very, very proud to really be over 40 billions of objects. So think about something very secure, developed by multiple partners across all the world. Very good success. And since a few years, we are investing also on the trusted execution environment technology. And we are very, very proud because we reached the 1 billion mark, and this is exciting, and that the impact that Global Platform may provide into the IoT world. So we have different technology, but we think that this is very important to give a clear guidelines for the users. And this is why we have decided to provide different technology, but that are really ranking in terms of robustness. So how much the technology protect the assets. And we know that in the IoT world, you may have different type of requirements. So today we are working on three level of security. High level of security, I talk about all technology from Global Platform, secure element, widely deployed with high protection against attacks. And we have this enhanced level that are aligned with the VAN 3 for those who knows common criteria, and where we have the TE protection profile. And again, we are working now on the MCU, microcontroller protection profile. So levels, as you see, are independent of the technology because you may answer to the same level of security in terms of requirement with different technology. I would like to focus right now more on the trusted execution environment, where Global Platform has been investing since 2016. And we have created a technical community that regroup labs, vendors, service providers, and also national certification bodies to work together and to try to have a complete vision of what needs to be done to answer market requirement in one end, but good products and evolutivity. Just before going into the TEE, I would like to show that we have currently products that are under review. This is our MCU protection profile. So you have the link here. I strongly encourage you to go on the Global Platform website and to make any comment you want. All our specifications are publicly available. And before the publication, we have a phase always, which is open to the public to allow anyone to make some comments. So welcome you to send comments on this MCU protection profile. Let's focus more now on the TEE. So TEE, it's the secure area inside the main silicon of the connected object. So the idea is not to add an additional component here. The idea is to really create an isolated environment into the main silicon chipset to provide high performance hardware security to applications. So this protect what we call trusted applications from unauthorized usage, unauthorized reading, unauthorized modification, protect, of course, all these secure trusted applications from the rich OS, but also each and every trusted application from each other. So really, this is a good way to implement specific IP, protect assets from an application. So if you take the point of the trusted application, what we provide with the trusted execution environment, and this is very important for the service provider. We provide, of course, isolation towards the regular execution environments, so-called OS of the device. We provide isolation, again, other trusted application. We provide application management control, who is able to load, who is able to put the application in hold, who is able to modify the application. Or, again, something very, very important in the connected world. We provide hardware-based device binding. Some use this term for root of trust. What is important to see here is that you need to know in which physical device you are. This is very important. Not really to know which device, because the hardware device doesn't give you any information, but to be sure that the execution, it's always the same and you have not been moved into a virtual world. And finally, you are in the bot platform or somewhere in the internet. No, you are in a specific device. This is very important. Of course, there is no security without state-of-the-art crypto. And of course, the trusted application get access through the API to this high-level and state-of-the-art cryptography. We are providing, of course, integrity and confidentiality of all the applications. So when the application store information within the TEE, the application knows exactly what kind of protection are managed by the TEE. And also, in this world where many devices are available, but sometimes the design is not exactly the same, you have privileged access to hardware, and I will come back to that, and peripheral, typically the trusted keyboard, the UI, the secure element, crypto engine, sensor. This is sometimes very difficult, and the TEE provide privileged access to this hardware, thanks to the protection into at the core of the device. So the TEE, again, isolate. Something which is very important is that there is different technology, but the objective of the TEE is to provide, again, enhanced level of technology, but fast communication mechanism between the TEE and the REE, and to really optimize how the hardware is able to protect the TEE from the REE. This is very important when you are using use cases where you need to manage a lot of data and typically a video flow. You must ensure that the video flow that always arrives from the rich OS is able to be decrypted, as an example, by the TEE very quickly. Of course, you may have multiple trusted applications that are active on the TE. This is really, I will say, a standard execution environment for applications. What is very important, again, for the service provider perspective, is that thanks to our compliance program, we are able to allow service provider to port application from device A with a specific hardware architecture to another device that have a different architecture. But thanks to the API and the interoperability of our trusted execution environment API, applications are portable across platform. This is very important for service provider that may not want to look all the details of the implementation of a secure core, a proprietary secure core. Here, they are able to use at least all the major API from the trusted execution environment through interoperable API. This is very important. Again, the secure storage, it's always complex for an application in two device, how I can protect my data here. By nature, the TE protects all the data of the application. And I will come back to that, but we have a TE protection profile that clearly defines the level of security, because it's always easy to say I'm secure, but we must be able to verify the level of security of the implementation. So in this case, and this is important, I think, for the RISC-V community, security by software, it's always difficult. So the TE require the hardware to provide specific features to create this isolated environment. Of course, we need to have a secure boot, but we need also to really protect and to be sure since the secure boot that the hardware is well used to protect the application. Something very important is that we are not selecting a specific way to protect through hardware. This is very important. We are our generic architecture and we have the TE protection profile. Any application that is able to provide a good level of security may be used to implement a interoperable global platform TE. This is very important. And this is why today we have different hardware implementation that are able to support TE. So the first one, as you see, you are in blue all the TE component. You may have in a PCB one chip which is managing a certain level of information and a specific chipset which is managing the execution environment in the PCB. You may have architecture that certainly most of you will recognize in which the hardware is able to switch from secure mode to unsecure mode. And then you are able to implement the TE using this switch mode. And you are able, of course, able to use on-chip secure subsystem. You know that the chipset today support multiple cores. You can dedicate a core to run the TE and which is using an external memory, which is also protected or separated from the other. So very various way to implement a TE. And I'm very, very happy to see that the discussion has started with RISC-V. There is different architecture that are ongoing within RISC-V. And we are working with the security working group of RISC-V to look, to verify that there is no issue for RISC-V to support or to add any new architecture. This is very important because Global Platform is here to ensure that the TE provide the right level of security, but we don't want at all to dictate any type of architecture. So this is a software part of the architecture. And of course, there is multiple way to implement. And TE, it's the combination of hardware and secure software solutions. You need to have the combination of two. What is very important for global platform, whatever you are creating, what kind of application, whatever design you want to create on your software, you must answer to this red line, which is the TEE protection profile. Very, very important. So what's the value of this tea and what we have a big success currently with a strong rate of deployment. Mainly because service provider wanted to have access to secure solutions. And it's very, very difficult to analyze each and every proprietary solution. Thanks to the TE, service providers are able to access to very complex API. I will give you two API. First, the Trusted User Interface. So what is a Trusted User Interface? This is really the possibility for the end user to be sure that they are answering to questions of the application and none of the other applications within the device are able to steal or listen what is happening. So we have two solutions, the high-level solution that provide really ready-to-use windows to allow service provider to immediately request that. We have a new version that we call the TE Trusted Low-Level API that really provide very strong access to all the display, all the input devices within the device, and to be sure that this action is protected by the TEE. So as an example, an obvious case, and this is why we have also a specific biometric API, but currently on the modern smartphone, most of the people are connecting using a fingerprint or using the face or using the voice. This is different sensors, and the TE ensures the application that when the application is requesting to get access or to validate or to check, none of application are able to read what is happening. So you have a direct and protected access from the application to the biometric system. This is very, very important. Not untrusted, trusted applications are able to access the biometric data. You are not able also when you lose a device to be hacked and your biometrics data are easily accessed. So everything is really protected. We support multiple users, multiple fingerprint. Each and every application are able to select a specific fingerprint. So you may have, fingerprint face. One application may request to have only fingerprint. Another application may want to use either fingerprint and face. This is very, very flexible, completely integrated into the hardware protection that are available on most of the device. So this is one example how the TEE APIs, standardized by Global Platform, help service provider to create very complex for the security perspective application, but finally that are very cool to use and very convenient for the user. So this is where you see the value of the TE standardized by Global Platform, because you get a possibility for the service provider to complex APIs, and you have, thanks to the certification, of course, you have an insurance that this is developed on the right way. So TUI, low levels, and biometrics are currently used in multiple use cases. I talk about the smartphone, but you know that on the cars, you have a lot of now systems that are able to do infotainment. You need to pay with your car. All this require to have end-user authentication. And thanks to the Trusted Execution Environment and the Trusted User Interface API, you're able to integrate within a car, within a TV, a very strong and secure solution that makes convenience authentication. Something which is allow sometimes complex, it's the management of the application. So Global Platform provide a framework that supports the management of application to be able, of course, to load, to block again, but also to manage this in a multiple actor ecosystem. Sometimes you have device manufacturer, service provider, you may need to have third party that are embedded within the device to provide CA type of services. So the number of actors are limited. The number of service provider actions, precise, I would say fine-grained access control is also possible. And we have possibility to do push or pull management of application online and asynchronous. So this model is very, very flexible. Allow device manufacturer, service provider, chipset manufacturer to really create the model they need to perform their business model. For your information, the last version of the TMF support ISN1 comments to have a very binary and standard way to describe the comments. And we have been also able to create OTRP model. You know, OTRP, it's a model also that is developed in IETF, and we are supporting this model, which is currently widely deployed also in Asia on standardized TE. So again, here, this is a very open framework that allow actors to create the right environment, the right infrastructure to deploy application, and of course, to create more value for the end user. Let's talk about now about the protection profile. I talk that you know, you can implement the TE as you want, and this is very important because we want to let any kind of hardware architecture to be supported within our environment. But we want another end to be able to verify that the TEE support and answer the right level of security. So we have here, you have here the latest version because we just received the new certificate that I here share for you. This TEE protection profile version 1.3 really applied the latest improvement of the CC technology. We have been working in collaboration with SC27 to be able to define more precisely some SFR, so some functional requirement, because we think that in our connected world, we need to have specific tools. So this protection profile use the latest version of ISO 7816 specification. We have an alignment in terms of, again, ISO world about our the requirement related to VAN. So now we are using AVAVAN AP.3. So this is the level of VAN 3. This is also very important in terms of modularity because not all the devices are supporting the same features. So we have three modules. The Secure Media Pass module to be able to do TVs, to be able to do home gateway that support TV on demand. We have the Trusted User Interface. I have introduced all these features to be able to ensure that, again, the input for the end user goes directly to the right trusted application. And I talk about biometrics. We have been working a lot with FIDO and with ICA and IFA in China to answer to the market requirement in terms of biometrics for this kind of market. So, again, here you have a strong technology that allows you to go to any laboratory that are common criteria and to be able to evaluate your technology towards this protection profile. And because sometimes some country they have not the right skills, we have since 4 years now created a certification body, and you may go to global platform and select a laboratory that has been accredited to be able to validate your TEE and to get a stamp from global platform. So this year will be a successful year for global platform because at least five products will be certified using our scheme. And this is very good because more and more service providers are requesting this stamp before loading the application. So we have more and more, of course, chipset vendors and device manufacturers that are going to global platform to, in order to get a certification for their product. Just few words about how to get this strong investment and to use it into the microcontroller world. So as I said, today we foresee that all the high-end and the mid-end IoT devices are able today to have an application processor which is, I will say, advanced enough to be able to support the full feature of the TE. And this is typically the case on the smartphone. But in IoT, we face some low-end IoT devices where all the features may not be necessary. And that we need to provide similar APIs and similar services, but trying to use a reduced set of resources. So this is why today we are working on the protection profile that adapts the TE concept to microcontroller, and that we think will be also a strong technology in the future to work with a new market. And in IoT, you know that there is a lot of verticals and a lot of ecosystem that are interested to have more security, to have certification. And certainly the MCU and this protection profile that focuses on the root of trust and how to create the isolation will be a good tool to get global platform technology deployed and developed in new markets. So RISC-V and global platform. We have signed an MOU, so now we have the link in place and between the two organizations to be able to work together to exchange and to collaborate to have a better and more secure IoT world. So thanks to this MOU that has been signed, we have started some discussion with the RISC-V Security Working Group, and that focuses really on the TE. And again, we think that there is one action that will be very good for both organizations is to have a lightweight configuration for the IoT. We need that again. Just present you why we think we need to have a lightweight configuration. But I think from the security working group from RISC-V, we see that also some targeted devices may not need all the features of the TE. So we are working and starting to work on this TE configuration for IoT, lightweight, and I'm expecting to have a lot of inputs from RISC-V experts to verify that all that has been created before with the global platform will be easily used within hardware provided by the RISC-V technology. So again, as a conclusion, service provider love the API and love to be able to use easily across platform very complex secure APIs and features. So thanks to the TE API, service provider are very able to create digital services that are very convenient. And this is what we are providing to the RISC-V, all these service providers that are already trained on the TE API. We have the protection profile today as a basis. We need to work with RISC-V to know if this is a good level of security. Do we need to have higher, lower? But this is important to show to service provider that the TE based on RISC-V answer to a specific and clear level of security. We are in full deployment with a strong rate. So we think that with RISC-V, this growth will be even stronger. And we are delighted to see this first discussion that will end with new technology and which allows both organizations to provide more secure tools and more secure devices to the end user, which is our goal to accelerate the deployment of secure devices into the IoT world. Thanks a lot for your attention. Here you have a few entry points. Our website is open. Most of the specifications are publicly available. So I strongly encourage you to look our technology and to join the work groups between Global Platform and RISC-V to accelerate deployment of secure digital services into the IoT world. Thanks a lot for your attention and talk to you soon.